Blackstone Audio presents No Time to Mourn by Tim Wohlforth. This book is read by Patrick Lawlor. To Joyce, Carl, and Bill. 1. She's back there. Lori gestured with her head toward a shape bent over a drink at the end of the bar. Hardly human. More like a bundle of black clothes someone had left on the barstool. I shivered, trying to shake off the dampness of the fog bank I had passed through to get to Big Emma's. As my eyes adjusted to the dim light, the bundle morphed into the semblance of a woman. She was around 50, with high cheekbones and a touch of wrinkle around eyes with dense pupils. Her black suit exuded quality, Neiman Marcus or Saks. Full red lips that matched bright dyed hair provided the only color. It was as if an artist had begun to colorize her just before she walked out of a frame in a 40s noir movie. A slight stiffening in her posture suggested she sensed she was being watched. She didn't look up, just kept staring into her glass. "See the way she clutches that drink?" I said. "You didn't tell me she's a lush." Lori looked up from polishing the mahogany surface of the bar. "Didn't used to be. Her name's Susan Henry. Came in here like clockwork every Friday for lunch with her husband, Edward. He'd order a martini. All she ever drank was a Virgin Mary. Then someone shot Edward. He died in her arms." "The black clothes. She's still in mourning." "I can't break her out of it." Lori returned to her polishing, platinum blonde ponytail bobbing up and down. She wore a white turtleneck sweater and a black skirt. A black velvet ribbon held her hair high up on her head. She used to be my lover, now my best friend. She runs Big Emma's, the Victorian bar on Jack London Square in Oakland that serves as my office. "So what can I do? I'm pretty good, but I don't bring back the dead. And I'm lousy at consoling. Become tongue-tied. That's your department."
"Keep her alive. She says the same killer is after her now."
Just what I didn't need. Lori dropping a murder case in my lap. "You know me," I stumbled ahead. "A bit of insurance fraud here, a skip trace there. Murders for cops."
"She's already seen the cops. They won't help her. She needs you, Jim."
Lori looked up into my eyes, doing that fluttering thing with her eyelashes. "I'll talk to her, but I'm not promising anything."
"Thanks, Wolf. You'll see."
What I could see was I was going to have a hell of a time talking my way out of this case. I grabbed my drink, Oban's single malt neat, and headed down the bar feeling like a killer on death row who knew the DNA would match. The place was half full, largely regulars. Two Port of Oakland engineers nodded as I sauntered by. Soon the after-work crowd would pour in. The interior of Big Emma's was dimly lit by ornate brass lighting fixtures with golden candle-shaped bulbs. A wide mirror in a carved oak frame covered the wall. Dice cups, some with players' names engraved on gold plaques, were stacked on a shelf in front of it. A large brass antique national cash register with monstrous keys stood in the middle. A tantalizing whiff of garlic and cheese floated through the air from the kitchen where cannelloni was being prepared. I wasn't expecting to hear the truth from Susan. They never tell all, human nature. Then you've got to use their money to find out the full truth. Part of the game all clients play. Worse, the deeper the trouble clients are in, the more they hold back. I get paid by the hour, so I shouldn't complain. Their decision, their bucks. But sometimes they pay for their reticence with their lives. Susan didn't look up as I slid onto the stool next to her, just kept staring into her glass.
"You are?"
she asked as she finally focused on me. At least her glass didn't have to bear the full weight of her intense glare anymore. "Wolf. Jim Wolf."
"Oh, Lori sent you. It is a pleasure to meet you."
She held out her quivering hand. I grabbed it and received a limp shake. She withdrew her hand from mine immediately. She smelled of lavender and whiskey. Lori tells me that someone...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.